One of the things that came up in the geek group's IRC is about CRTs, and basically this is a video to show the safe working on a CRT. In front of me I've got the monitor from my BBC B+, and it's a cub, all metal framed on this one. Other monitors might be plastic framed or whatever, but the principles are basically the same. The problem with a CRT is the tube itself can be is actually a capacitor, being fed by a higher voltage. You don't want to be touching that without making sure it's discharged. And the person in question basically is worried about how big the bang would be and how to discharge it safely and what size wire to use, because it's going to be a high current and everything else. So I thought I'd make this video quickly. It's going to be a quick and dirty to go into it. I did a tour of this monitor a little while back. I'll put a link in the description if you want to go back through it. But this is about safely working on it to clean it, clean the dust and everything else. So mostly about the discharging of the tube and any other capacitors that might be on the board. Particularly there's a mains rectifier and smoothing capacitor on there as well. So I'm going to reset the cameras so you get a good view inside, and we'll get on with it. So first thing I'm going to do, just so you know this is all genuine, I'm going to power this there we go, that's firing up, and you may be able to see just down the back here the tube is glowing, and when I just started it out there was a couple of little crackles. So now I'll turn that off and unplug it, that to one side. Now discharging size of cable. I'm just going to be using one of these standard clip leads. Although the current is quite high in these capacitors or in this tube, it's only for a short duration. So yeah, this thin lead will do the job that we need to do. Now clipping on to a ground, I've taken this point here, which is basically a woven steel wire that goes around the back of the tube. It's obviously got some sort of grounding feature on it, because the ground from the chassis goes onto the metal case, and then it goes forward onto one of the terminals, which in turn is actually connected to this steel wire. You also got the corner bolts. Just show you one up the top there. There's the corner bolts there, on usually onto a metal plate. I don't know whether I'd guarantee that, but you know, you could do a couple of discharges. You know, if you got a wire, then do it on the wire. You could also do it on the corner to be on the safe side. And if you've got an obvious earthing point, this one probably has, because this is a three core and you've got the earth pin of the mains flex. So there's points there you can take earth from, and if you're not sure, do them all. Now the way to do this, I zoom in. To the top connection, actually it might be better. I don't know what clarity we'll get. Oh yeah, we'll get pretty good clarity, but I'll also make sure the camera is also showing that point there. I'll show the top cap in a bit greater detail once I've discharged this, but basically get the screwdriver under the cap. And what you want to do is imagine that you've got a bit of a rise on the back of the tube for the connection, so you want to come back towards the connection, and then you just push it underneath, wiggle it under. You should be able to get to the centre. This one is not that easy, but I think I'm in the centre, and there wasn't actually any bang on this one. No, that's definitely in the centre, and I'm not getting any bang on it. We can't always be safe. This has just been fired up, so I'm going to use pair pliers gently, because remember you've got glass, just wiggle it out, and that's the cap off. Put that to one side, making sure it's not going to touch anything, and then just to be on the safe side, there shouldn't be a capacitor on this, but touch the pins on the inside. And then bring the screwdriver over to the hole and work it round. Now this one has discharged, which is quite amazing really, but sometimes you get a bit of a pop, sometimes you don't, sometimes you get a bit of a loud crack. Be aware, you know, it's going to be no louder than a good, you know, clap of the hands. So that's the tube discharged. I will just make sure by going on an alternative grounding point, like I mentioned, and going the top. And that is discharged on there. So now the tube is totally safe to touch. But you don't need to touch it if you're just cleaning the board, etc. You know, if it's not necessary to touch it, then don't do it. And I'll just do a check on the pins on the back of the clip. Right, I said I'm going to do a close-up of this clip so that you might understand it a bit more. Okay, so that's the underside of the clip, and you can see these spring terminals. Sometimes it's just like a bit of wire, sometimes it's clips. Yeah, this one's actually got four sort of prongs on it that go into that hole, and because you've got the shape of the cap, when you get your screwdriver, you don't just go in, because this is obviously got to go into a hole in the back of the tube, so you want to angle the screwdriver up, and you want to be able to get to the centre of the clip. Some of these rubbers are different shapes, they're more like a sucker than this squarer shape, but in any case, yeah, that's the point that you want to get to, right in that centre. If you're not sure, get a pair of insulated pliers, pull the cap off and be careful, and then poke the screwdriver onto the clip and onto the back of the tube. That's discharged, I'm safe. In the back of this one, there is also the main circuit. I've gone through that in a bit more detail on the other video, but we've got a mains capacitor there. Not sure what the voltage is, we'll come to that at another point. But it should be a discharge resistor across it, but we can't be sure. And there's other various capacitors as well. I'll show you a neat way of making sure you're totally safe. So okay, I've taken the back panel off. There's several plugs on this board, so I've pulled those out. Obviously being careful not to touch anything. And then what I'm going to do is unclip the board. Okay, the board is unclipped, and what we're going to use is piece of kitchen foil, just ordinary aluminium foil, and what I'd do is just scrunch it a bit, and that gives you a bit of an uneven surface to rest your board on. Now again, be aware that there may or may not be any high wattages. I'm not sure if I can reach this. Just turn the board out and then lift up the foil, keep your hand behind it, and just pat around the board. Now, say this is mostly a method for those of you that are a bit paranoid, and I can understand that. And there's backboard on the tube again. You know, it's going to short out on the foil before it shorts out on you. So that's the board totally safely discharged. You know, there was no sparks or pops or anything, so I'm happy to work on this board and give it a good clean. And on the point of cleaning, someone suggested a toothbrush. That might be all right for underneath, but yeah, you're not really going to get into any of the stuff on the top. And the best tool I find for the job is this is an old paintbrush that's been used, and it's a little bit on the stiff side. Obviously, if it's a bit stiff, then it's a lot better, and you can actually get in amongst the components, being a bit careful not to disturb too much. You can also use a soft one if you're a bit worried about certain components, but as you see, you can be reasonably rough with it without being too rough. Just make sure that the brush is dry. A lot of our carcinoma problems are because there's a build up of dust, high voltage attracts dust around the place, and that absorbs moisture from the air, gets a little bit damp, and it starts to arc. And I think that's about it. So use several points of grounding if you're not sure. As I say, there's the wire on the back of the tube, there's the corner connections. There might be an obvious grounding point, as there is this one on the metal case, or mains earth. Try them all. Use the kitchen foil on the back of the board to make sure other capacitors are discharged, and you should be totally safe to do whatever work you need to do on it.